Well, this next story is an example of that intangible quality known as grace under pressure. Ozaukee County dispatcher Michael Ives displayed an abundance of it, and so did Patricia Hallam after her husband David collapsed in the driveway of their Saukville home.
The drama was celebrated today at an Ozaukee County ceremony with all of the players in attendance. Dispatcher Michael Ives was there, as was Patricia Hallam. The real cause for celebration, though, a smiling David Hallam showing no signs of his brush with death just over a month ago. When David collapsed in his driveway, Mrs. Hallam was on the phone quickly. Ives spoke in measured tones, fully aware a life was on the line.
Okay, we've got help on the way. I've got a few more questions to ask you, okay? Just stay in the line and I'll tell you exactly what to do next.
Okay.
Clearly, Ives' calm, confident voice was just what Patricia Hallam needed to hear.
Lay him flat on his back.
Okay.
Okay. And can you tell me, is he breathing?
The question was followed by an agonizing pause.
No, he's not.
Okay. All right, what I need to do is listen very carefully, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do right now is I'm going to walk you through doing CPR until help gets there, okay?
Okay.
So listen carefully and I'll tell you how to do chest compressions, okay?
Ives gave Mrs. Hallam detailed instructions telling her to counter compressions out loud.
13, 14, 15. She's breathing.
What's that?
She's breathing, I said.
Okay. Just keep going, okay?
When police and deputies pulled up, Ives stayed on the phone with Hallam. She wasn't ready to say goodbye.
Okay. All right, let me know when the deputies are right there with you, okay?
I mean, they're right here.
Okay. All right, I'm going to disconnect with you, okay?
Not yet.
Okay, that's fine. I can stay here with you.
Ozaukee County Dispatch, by the way, partnered with Aurora Healthcare just last year to train dispatchers to give medical advice before paramedics arrive to save lives when the pressure is on.